Just regular cash grind, no tournaments today. On the list for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more tables. So we will see how quickly we can get on. Oh, I was sitting here waiting for 20 minutes. Now they're all fucking coming out. Okay, great. Literally, I was sitting here for 20 minutes. I was like, I'll just get started with 2, and then 3 jump up immediately. That's hilarious. Something right about there. Damn, is that blind versus blind? Yeah, it was too. No, it was first position. Called 3 ways. Leads, call, check, lead, jam on this board with King 8. Not really the thing. Okay, good to know. Who is that guy? It's this guy. Alright. This down just a little. Okay. There we go. Cool. No real hands have gone off yet. Looks like we're gonna be able to play all 9 max, because I'm still on the waiting list for 4 more, so that'll give a good rotation. Hopefully we'll just be jumping in and out of tables. I can wait there. This one's done. Hey, there's the 6th. That's close enough. That's why all the tables popped up, a lot of people left. Still 3 more full tables, so not bad. I was gonna say I gotta go with range over here. This player does play loose. The Kings obviously is not bad, but he does play quite a bit looser than I would expect. But I don't think range is 5 betting anything less than aces. All right, first playable. I think we can go ahead and raise this one. Okay, I could 3 bet that, but I kind of like the call there. Alright, We'll check the gut shot. Ace isn't great. We can actually bet this one. Kinda small. Player calls, straight comes off. Let's go ahead and bet again. Get check raised, don't love that. How often is this player full? So it's eights, ace seven, or sixes. Yeah, I think I gotta call this one. Whoa. He was trying to represent the hand I had. It's an interesting technique, sir. I'm not going to continue betting on that board unless I'm absolutely strong. That's kind of weird. I'll take it. Check, check, check. Yeah, and he raised small out of first, I think, right? Or was he posted? Yeah, he posted out of first. That's why he went for that. He posted and made a small raise on top of it, so it looked like he raised out of first. But yeah, he did post. That's funny. Well, don't expect the best play out of somebody who posts in first position, so... Not even reloading. We might have a target. It's dead jam. Wow, that's crazy. So not bad. I think we're gonna go a little heavier on this one. Get called by the limper. Yeah. Not so much worried about that when the heart comes off. I was gonna say if he checks, I should check back, but if he jams, I'm never folding. Cause that's just, yeah, that's just all around bad. That's just donkey shit. Limp called representing a set and then jam when the flush hits the board? Yeah, I don't think so. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, sir. It's kind of like this guy. Oh, I got timed out. What the fuck? Get 3-bet by every day when I raise under the gun and he's in the small. He does 3-bet often, but I'm going to let the ace-queen offsuit go. 3-bet by my buddy over here. I don't mind that. Let's see how crazy he is. It's pretty crazy. But the thing is, he's not going to fold. I have him on a pair. So, if there was two clubs, I would go for the check raise, but he never has a king there. So, but he's not going to fold like a pair of eights or something. Eights or nines. I suppose it's possible he could have a king, but... I'm kind of not going to give him a lot of credit off the bat. Posted in over here, called a raise. I think that's an easy call. This is an easy check. Let's check this one back. He could definitely have just beaten me on the turn, but I think we just checked down. Yeah. Might win this one. Nope, ace jack. Good play. It's actually smart to check it there. I may have bet the river, though. Because really the only hand that I'm playing that way where I'm just going to bet the river is the flop king-queen, which would be the worst way to play it. But I get it. I think if you have king, or if you have like jack-king or something like that, or like just a solo jack, I think it's better to check down. I think when you have the ace-jack, you should actually probably bet the river. Because I'm going to call you with any kind of pair. Most of the time. Because one of us should have bet at some point. Look at this. This is a limp pot that was checked down. And then a full pot bet on the river. And a jam. So this makes an interesting situation with these two players. Normally this is a 3-bet. But I think we're going to far too often see a jam here out of hands like ace-jack, ace-queen. So it opens up to too many races, so I think I'd rather just take a safe flop and then play from there.
I think I'm going to order from Sal's.
This player calling is kind of weird. Okay. The ace really sucks.
I was just going to get the tin chicken fingers plain with ranch and hot sauce on them. Get me a mac and cheese.
Okay. This is the problem. So I should probably have raised the flop, but I think this is more than likely the best hand. I don't even think he has to worry about a diamond. So this is just air balls. I can't believe that guy folded. Him calling is kind of really bad. If he hadn't called on the flop, I would have check raised and probably won it right there on the flop.
Do you want anything?
No, I can't. I don't think I can do well with what I'm going to get from Sal's.
Okay. Well, I'm getting the 10 fingers, so if you want a couple of chicken fingers, you can have
those. Going to let range go there. It's kind of a big open. There's one limper, so it's kind of standard. So I guess it's standard. Let's go ahead and re-raise. Jack. Yeah, take it down. Okay. He's always going to have the weird shit. See how much smaller the pot is when he actually had a value hand? That's how you can tell. That is a huge raise and call. Okay. That's a pretty good flop for two diamonds. See the check from the original raiser. It's a little scary. And this player taking a while is going to be whatever. I think we just bet half pot. Kind of try to bring a king along. If nobody calls there, nobody goes any further. Bet the ace. Get called. Bet the ace again. Range is going to have some two pair combos here, which is kind of weird. I think we just go three bets and let him fold ace seven on the river. It's just a straight value play. He usually has a better ace there, but I think it's kind of really hard for him to call with one pair with like ace 10. He just kind of has to see a bet three times. So Brevin likes to be over aggressive. I'm going to 3-bet to try to get him heads up in position. Not easy from early, but well, looks like we got it. Also didn't want every day's 3-betting, which he's prone to do when I just call. Calls. I think we just go ahead and bet. Take it down. Nice small bet. Take it down. It's not bad. Kind of looks a lot stronger there coming out of an early position. Could 3-bet the ace deuce, but on a 9-handed table, I don't love it. 6-handed, pretty good for a squeeze. This is a very small raise. Just trying to get heads up with me. And let's check back the queen. That's kind of a bad run out for my range. I'm going to check. Wow, just an ace. Nice. Aces. Let's make a good sized raise. If they can't fade a raise, then we don't want to play against them. Not the worst. I think we just bet. Pretty small. Every day is going to have a lot of check raises here. He's going to have a lot of our hearts. He's going to have a lot of raggedy aces. He's going to have some 4 or 5 of hearts. Yeah, he's going to have a ton of check raises here when he comes out of the blind. I'm just going to let it go. Even though I have the queen of hearts, I think it's fine because I kind of understand that I'm better off there, but versus his total range, I'm gonna lose. Meaning I'm like 60% sure I have the best hand, but I think he has better than that equity against me. What do I know about you? Okay. I'm not going to defend that. If it was suited, I would. Nope. Every day's really likes to play out of the blinds, so I don't mind walking the really worst stuff to him. Better just to give up half a blind. There versus the limper in early position. Revan's just calling because he's worried about this being a trap. But it's a fold, so I'm gonna go ahead and bet small. He can have some jacks, he can have all the diamonds. He calls. The ace in the turn isn't the worst. I'm gonna check. Just because I kind of want to see. Yeah. Yeah, I really, as much as this is insane, I really got to give him credit here for two pair. Because he three bets so often. I mean, I know we had an early position limper, but he three bets so often that I don't think he's betting just an ace there. So if he doesn't have a flush, then he has good outs that allow him to bluff river. There's some argument to be made for betting small and then bigger on the turn 100% against a player like that, but when he doesn't 3-bet me, I gotta feel like this is definitely, you know, suited connector, wheelhouse, two pairs or flushes or even like sets, you know, because I shouldn't have the suited. And the only thing I can have is the suited king, queen of diamonds at that point, and most players don't 3-bet that. But this is a little loose, but this table seems kind of aggressive, but it'll pay off. So it's kind of spot where we want to be playing most pairs. And I think we can bet here for value. Get called. I think we have to continue the story. He calls. Spade on the river is really bad. I don't know if he'll ever go for the bluff with less than that. Drew the whole way. I could have made a smaller 3-barrel structure, but I really don't think he's ever got anything other than spades there. Especially calling in position. enough history on this player. I could have half pot blocker bet it, but I think he can also have some sets, which is kind of weird. I think we're better off just giving up. Could have just checked that flop too. I think maybe that was the move, is check this flop and then bet turning river. Yeah. Because my hand kind of looks like a pair of tens or jacks or something. So I think it's better. Yeah, I didn't think about that. Six. No bets there. Ace 10 limp. Yeah, okay. Interesting. He's got a false impression he's trying to play pots with me. Maybe he's trying to play pots with everybody. I don't mind this. Let's raise. This player's usually very aggressive, but I've seen him limp and call just a ton today. Definitely gonna bet. Gonna make it look kind of funky because I should be way ahead. Really? I think we just call in this scenario. He's gonna have Jack 10 a bunch. He's gonna have some pairs. I do think I want to raise the turn. Yeah, that's what I thought. The point of raising the turn is that he's not gonna continue to bluff the river, so raising the turn is kind of where we pull the trigger and get him to go ape shit with a king 10 or ace 10. But everything else he would have raised bigger on the flop, so nice. Quick double. That's not bad. Thing is, because of the raise preflop, he probably automatically just put me on big cards instead of a pair. Call this one. I kind of like this on the button sometimes, especially from a late position raiser. Keeping the pot small is kind of good. So, he bets small standard. I'm just going to go ahead and call. Jack on the turn is pretty awesome. We still have to fade it, though, so I think we want to get some value here. Because my hand's going to look more like a bluff than anything else. If he has the ace of hearts, he won't fold. If he doesn't, he might think I have it. Get 3-bet by a short stack sitting for about an hour who doesn't reload. I think we're just going to call, look for a little safer flop than that, and then get the money in. But you don't want to race with these guys because they're just going to roll over, you know, bigger pocket pairs a ton. Let's go ahead and raise. This is a small open pre, so he can have it. It's fine. Got a slice here. 3-bet by stacks, sitting for 3 minutes. He can have it. I think when you're one of the few players who has raise folds, like raising preflop and then folding to a 3-bet, I think you kind of, in this field, I think you kind of hold a super advantage. So a lot of these players will just call a 3-bet if they opened, even though they're opening properly. Like, my 6-5 is a proper open on the button, absolutely. But you're not supposed to call a raise. This, you know, if another player had called, or if this player had made the raise and then the big blind had cold called, then we could call, closing the action, you know, in position with a suited connector for, you know, a 3-bet pot. But I don't think it's really a great idea to be calling those, even if you're in position. I mean, I know it's not. But you see so many of these players who make that raise, call the 3-bet. So this player limped. I'm just going to bet super small. He limped, called a raise. I think we have to bet something to build a pot here. So, and he'll call with like a pair, 7s or 5s or something, or 6s, whatever it was. 5s are nice. Hey, we're up a buy-in. Look at that. 25 minutes? I don't mind that. Oh, thank you. Pocket tens again. I'm not going to bother. Seeing a lot of limping happening. Is Dave going to go for it? There's a limper in first. It kind of makes it hard for him to go for the squeeze. There's a limper in first. Can be trapping, which is fucking hilarious that people are still doing that like it's 2005. Ace isn't the worst. I think we're just going to go ahead and bet. Once we get the fold behind, we should be good. Player up front calling is kind of weird. He can definitely have something, but I think we just have to keep betting here. Wow, that's the worst card in the deck. Because he can jam everything here, and I can't ever call. Nice play. This is like an ace rag. It was like the suited ace of spades, and he just got there on the river. He never has the four. Probably had something like the ace 10 of spades or something like that. There's no real argument for checking the turn there. Because he's going to have, like, his pocket nines and shit like that a lot. Or lower. And, so, we just have to bet twice. It's really a value play. Him leading the river is kind of hilariously bad. Because you're only going to get called by something that beats you, and he never has the four. You know, there was very few. I mean, the only one he could have is the suited. No, he can't even have the suited ace four of diamonds. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and bet here. I mean, this is just to make my hand look like what it is. When we get called behind and the heart comes off, I think we can actually check without giving anything away. I don't know if a raw 5 wants to bet here. So this should really only be flushes and full houses. Don't really know why this player was calling. Problem is, range could just be using his position there, but this player out of first, I don't understand the limp call. Like, the limp, I can get it. Some people will limp with any pair and then, you know, whatever, but calling on that flop after your call behind is kind of really bad. Yeah, I really don't like it. Nope. I'm on three more waiting lists, so. That'd be c-betting a little bit too much. But got my best hands out of position, which kind of means I kind of have to. Don't love it, but I think we can defend. Oof, love that 10, but then the ace just pops right off. I think we can go ahead and check, actually. I was going to bet it, but Seymour can be doing something. I think we just check down at this point. I mean, this player can definitely have queens or jacks or something and not love it, so he may block or bet. It's kind of hard not to call $2 here or like 250 or something like that. But I don't think he's checking kings three times, so I might just be good here. Yeah. Let's go ahead and 3-bet to get heads up. 4-5 out of first and king jack. I thought this player was more ABC, but I guess not. 4-5 of clubs out of first. Interesting. So no positional care whatsoever. Ooh. Four-way pot with a set. Yeah, let's go ahead and bet. No free cards, people. Pair the board, please. I mean, there is 8-9 out there, but this player's only got 20 bucks, so I think we just charge him. This is a point where I can never fold, even if a heart comes off. And I think we just take our time. Put him in. Drew for 80% of his stack. Granted, he was short, but just so this player opens everything, so it's kind of hard to say, although I don't really love my hand. It's more of a trapper, so actually the check kind of worries me. King of the turn's not great. There's no real reason to bet. We pretty much have a bluff catcher. Unless an ace hits the river. I mean, an ace, that's pretty much it, right? So I don't think we have to block or bet. I think we just call a bet. Should just win a bunch, right? Ace 9's pretty good. Yeah. No real reason to bet. I mean, I guess you can technically bet the river, but I think ace 10 or ace jack has to be the minimum. Yeah, it's kind of weird. What did everybody have? Yeah, he's raising queen jack in first, 6-7 over here. Yeah. The ace 5 is kind of whatever, but I mean, we're both kind of in the similar situation, so maybe a half pot bet on the river. Ace 9's kind of right on the line, though, so it's probably supposed to be a bet. It's probably a mistake. But it's one of those ones that's so, it's going to come around so rarely that, like, who gives a shit? You know, it's like, yeah, I could have made an extra 5 or 6 blinds, but that situation is not going to happen often enough. Oh, that is a lot of chips to give up in that scenario. From the big blind. So, raises out of first, gets called 3 times. Called again, just jams the turn right into 2 outs. Wow, that's hilarious. That's really bad. But it's that time of night, people kind of flip out. I'm surprised I can't get on these other tables. I'm first on all the list. Well, see, there you go. As soon as I said it. Not bad. Seeing the post-WSOP player pool enhancement. There's a lot more people playing that I think got accounts during the World Series. Nah, I can't play threes out that early. There's one player missing, so cutoff, hijack, low jack. Low jack opener minimum is 6-6, I think. 6-6 or 5-5. No, yeah, it's 6-6. It's like 8-7-6, yeah. And then 5-5 in the hijack. Again, this is that short stack player. We're just trying to outflap him. I think we'll check here. I mean, this is one of those ones where it's an easy bluff, but this player is super fat, and he's only been here 30 minutes, so we're not going to attempt anything complicated versus a ABC 50 and L player. Like, yeah, I steal the pot there maybe 40% of the time, but when I don't, I kind of lose too much because I have to bet flop and turn. This could get spicy. Well, we're obviously checking, taking the free card. This guy leads out. I don't think we fold. That's interesting. Don't think we have bluffs here, because this should be a pair of ton, so we're going to let it go, because this is either the ace or like a pair of nines or something. So I don't really think there's bluff raises. I mean, that's the way you would play an ace, especially like a bad ace, like ace-8 that filled up or something, but it's just a full house, usually. Posting in a second. It's just good to realize that shit when somebody... This is the guy who limped before and then ran out the full house board, or the quad board. So, I don't really expect him to not have stuff when he bets. Like, you think because a bad player is there, a bad, you know, they're a bad player, they're going to be like, oh, you know, they're bluffing all the time. Bad players don't really bluff. Like, bad players just kind of overvalue their hands. I mean, he had some bluffs, but not many. He's kind of just betting a jack there. Bad players do like to semi-bluff, so he could have had a gut shot. Like the king 10 made a pair. Or whatever it was, jack 10. Another limper. I'm going to underplay the ace. It's not bad. I think we call. King's not really a huge concern. Kind of depends on the size of his bet. I think we can call here. He can definitely have King Jack. He can definitely have some Ace 7 combos, I suppose. But usually he's just bluffing, right? Yeah. He could have had a worse Jack, like Jack 10, I guess, right? What do you have? 9-8. Yeah, he's just kind of semi bluffing. That's that bad player thing again. Like, he limped, which means he has no real strength to his hand, but then the board improves him, so he picks up a gut shot and a flush draw, and he was just kind of blocker betting down. But open under the gun. Need a deuce on two tables. Ooh, I got one of them. Guess we just call. I mean, 4-5 gets there, but I never have 4-5, so I think we just have to worry about stacks having jacks in this scenario. And we're just going to bet because, or we're just going to call because I don't want to blow him off of the bluff. And I also don't want to give him my stack when he does have jacks. When he checks the river, sometimes he can have the jacks here and be trying to induce my bluff. But I think we go for the big bet because he's going to have over pairs a ton. He's going to have like queens and kings. He's going to have some ace jack, but I think he actually was just on the flush draw or the cold bluff. So he gave it up way too quick because it doesn't look like I have anything. Like these guys don't over trap the set. Like we're already heads up, so like if my opponent has the suited like ace king of clubs or something, it's not going to slow down. So you know, there's no real reason to raise until we get to the turn. But I just didn't even feel that's what was going on. It's just one of those ones where I just kind of got a feeling. Paid off pretty good. I gotta go pee. I'll be right back. Alright. Get back into this. Ooh, big blind queens. Get raised. I think we're gonna go ahead and go for the three bet. I'm gonna open the king jack. Get called here. I think we're gonna go ahead and bet bigger. I mean, does he ever have aces or kings? Sometimes, but when we get the action here, it's usually jacks and tens. I was watching a thing recently from a while back, but it still stands true that like you make the majority of your money from the big pairs. So you should really be betting bigger when you hit. Like, he doesn't give me anything there, but he doesn't give me anything with ace-king anyway. So, fuck it. Don't want to fold here. I think we want to call this one. I think it's got just enough equity. Sometimes we get three bet off behind, but for one blind, yeah. Raising a call. Wow, straight jammed it. Again, I think we're just gonna bet pretty big here. I don't think we see too many set jams. We can, but we can definitely see jams from tens and jacks. But again, I think it's just better to bet bigger there. Does this guy... This guy might have been the guy who... Yep. I'm thinking of a hand I played against him last week. Yeah. He jams big pairs there. Which is fine. I mean, it keeps you from getting cracked. I get it, but... The sizing's okay. Once you get called, though, you kind of have to give up. Or you can check turn and bluff river. I mean, because this can be 9-10 also, but it can also be a lot of 8s. It can be a lot of jacks. So, I'm not 100% sure if you want to keep barreling here without the overpair. I'm going to 3-bet again. I get to 3-bet on the same table twice within 3 hands. Yeah, see, this is... Wow, he tripped out the 4. That's funny. So just fold this one, check this one, fold this one. Everybody folds here. What did you have? Did he have aces? Oh, wow. Did he bet small on the turn? That might have been the problem. He checked. You never check that turn. You have to bet that turn. That's exactly why. Wow. He just shut it down and let himself get drawn out on. Yeah, I think I'm betting big on that turn with it. Like I said, if you have the overpair, you have to bet big, because if you have a jack, it's less likely your opponent has a jack. So what is he calling you with? When you have aces, kings, or queens there, your opponent's going to have a jack. So just bet big. And it's one of those ones where if he calls you with that jack, great, but he's only going to check raise you with the 8, and he's not going to continue with the 4. So you kind of can't go wrong betting like 3-quarter pot there, because he's going to give up the 4. You know what I'm saying? Because now he can't even hit the 3, but when the 4 hits the river, he can absolutely bet right into you. Because obviously you're afraid of an 8, you're equally afraid of a 4. You don't have trip jacks, or jacks full, you know? So yeah, I don't like that. I think that's... And it's hard in-game to recognize that shit, but... Aces... These are fun. On the button, raising. Stacks might 3-bet kind of wide. This player, again, coming in limping. I don't think he folds here. Wow, he actually did fold. Look at that. We can fold. I'm surprised. I really thought if this player had called, they both would have called, which would have been all right. Look at this. The raise right at it. That was really quick. Open here. I don't think I want to dead fold the king jack. Well, now I can. Fold that one. You alright?
Yeah.
Oh. Just... Probably should have called this one, but Drew's going to 3-bet a lot, so is Forever. And Stacks in the big blind. He's going to 3-bet a ton. Yeah, I think this is a better fold. I think 8-7, yeah, for sure, or 8-9, but 8-5 might be a little bridge too far. I'll have to look that up later. It's kind of great when they both check, though. Getting 8-1. So I kind of have to call, because if those are 5s. Da, 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 da. Huh. King queen. Did he 3-bet that? I'm kind of curious. No, it was a limp and he just made a big raise. That's hilarious. Bet, raise, call after the limp. And then they check it down. You guys are ridiculous. That is just a bad play. Limp the king, queen, and then did that. That's just a bad play. And then I think you'd have to bet the river here if you have the ace, queen. I mean, at least you should. Like, what are you worried about? Because it looks like he's raising to control for the flush draw. When the flush misses, you can actually bet. It's not bad. I'm going to check it. I could definitely bet it, but I sometimes get blown off my equity. So Seymour bets the full pot. This is an attempt to blow me off my equity without anything great. Does he do this with one pair? I think he does this more with draws, so we're going to raise and get it in with him versus a flush draw a lot. The problem is he can have a 5-6 here. He could have like the 6-7 of diamonds. Or one pair, which I have way too many outs against. It's kind of weird. My initial reaction, I swear to God, I didn't say it out loud, but my initial reaction was he's overplaying one pair. Which makes a lot of sense because he's trying to kill the flush draw. But when I raise and you don't get it in with that one pair and then I jam turn, you kind of have to call. I don't even know what he was really thinking about. So that's kind of weird. Yes, I'm going to ditch just that quickly. Oh, I just missed the seat. Fold. There's another one here I think I can get on. Yes, I can. All right, dead table. I will take it. 15 outs versus king, queen, which, like I said, it was my initial reaction, is that he would have that. But when he just calls the flop, that's a really bad play. Like, he should be looking to call the flop and jam turn when I check. But when I call the when he calls my re-raise and then I jam the turn, he should only be folding. That's just not... I mean, and I got lucky, right? But I had 15 outs. So, by the time I jam the money in, it's a good play. Nice. Up 2 buy-ins. In about an hour. I'll take that. Pick up a buy-in every half hour. That's $100 an hour hourly rate. Which, when we run right, is very sustainable. Why is my phone brightness turned all the way up? That's weird. Little ace, queen of diamonds. Yeah, I think it might be good for me to just stick with the 9 max for a little while. The 6 max, there's so much nuance to it, and I've gotten much better at 6 max, but I kind of would rather play the 9 max, so maybe we'll just be looking for those games for the next 5-6 days, because the volume might be fucking me if it's 6 max. It's too much variable play. You win, sir. So, super small bet. We can definitely get raised behind by a lot of top pair and two pair combos, but I definitely don't think we fold yet because of that. Now it kind of depends what he does. Sometimes players bet super small when they smash it, and then they bet bigger on the turn. But even versus kings here, we have 12 outs. So, he bets big. This player behind is kind of the issue. I don't think we fold. King on the river. kind of bad. Because if he was bluffing, he got there. And if he wasn't bluffing, he's not afraid of that king. So, yeah. You got it, bro. Aces are good. Probably aces. A lead from the blind and a call from the blind. The lead from the blind is nothing big, but the call from the blind is kind of the problem, especially when it's an ABC player. So. Now the bet. Yeah, this donkey shit here. Ooh, top set. I mean, we can check this one all day. I don't really advocate slow play, but it's a five-way pot with no real connection. And a player like this who's going to overplay a hand. Well, the five makes a lot of connections, but got shots and stuff. So when we see this bet, I think we just call. Did this get queens twice on this table in a row? I think I did. Huh, yeah, I did. Well, it was one hand in between. I think we call here. The deuce on the river really sucks because an ace makes a straight and a flush card gets there. I guess we just check. He had the case nine. That's funny. So we bet and get called. Three on the turn's not the worst. I think we just keep betting. This wasn't as big as before, but he's not going to have over pairs that beat me, so it's really just about 8-6. And he could have 5-7, but it didn't change anything on the river, so unless he has pocket fours or a six here, I think we win. We just check, try to catch a bluff, like with pair of nines or something. It's pair of nines, look at me. I'm surprised he didn't bet. He would be turning it into a bluff, but it's kind of a good play anyway. It's not bad. King 10. He didn't even take another shot. I think the 10 slowed him down. Full pot bet. Look at this. The problem here is the ace of hearts. I don't know where it is. So. A lot of times that flush is good, but so's calling behind. I'm not sure. Because what else is he calling with? Like, he could have sets, right? But when this player bets that big, he never has the flush draw. So the ace of hearts is very likely. I think I saved myself money. I think I would have been flush over flush. Because any suited ace could be there as a single raise pot. And I don't think so. Just betting twice there without the ace of hearts at least. So, it's just a question of if he had another one, and since this player's coming out of first, and I have the queen and the jack, the ace king of hearts isn't in his hand, because there was no three bet, so he can definitely have, like, an ace five, an ace four of hearts, and have gotten there, so I think it's fine. Sometimes we have to give it up, or sometimes we're giving up the best hand, but I don't think I can blast it, right? Like, I can only check call twice, and win, like, a medium-sized pot. So it's not even the best situation, so I'm fine with giving it up. It just kind of sucks when you see the flush come off and you don't get to see the showdown. This is too loose. I'm going to fold that. I think we just check down here. Ten's kind of meh. Might win. Yeah. I see a lot of checking in the 9-max, so I don't mind defending a little wide in the small. Usually don't want to have too many calls in the small, but there was no raise, so it's just a flat. Queen's nice.
Oi.
Okay.
I had 300 million yesterday. I don't even have 500,000. <Da-na-na-na-na. laughs> I got cocky.
That's what happens. I'm gonna go ahead and bet this one.
Decided to play the high limits. That's where all the good games were.
Story as old as time in Vegas.
Man. 10 million to spin. That 300 million went real quick.
I just saw a great YouTube video of a guy who had never played a slot machine in his life. And his buddies all lived in Vegas. So they came out, and he said that his gambling budget was $1,000. And he has no concept of slots. So they walk into the Bellagio. He walks right up to the first slot machine he sees and puts in $100. And his buddy goes, whoa, that's $100 to spend. And he goes, yeah, I got enough. And he spins it, and he hits a fucking 14K jackpot. And his buddy just grabs him, and he goes, I want you to understand, this is not this will ruin your life. This is not the way this goes ever. Please don't go crazy. It's like, and his other buddies are on the floor just rolling around. They're like, it's his first spin.
Yeah, no.
He literally just goes, yeah, I got enough. Just spun it for a fucking hundo. It was so great. I was so glad they were filming.
Those chicken fingers are very filling.
I mean, they're chicken and bread.
Two and a half of them, I'm like,
so this guy, yeah, he bets the fucking draw, and then he just pound, pound, pound. That's good value, actually, he got there. I kind of like that. It's kind of really good. He could have probably gotten more. Once the ace pairs the turn, I think you just go big, or when the ace makes the turn, you just kind of go big, because you're going to be up against a set a ton. Like, you can go three-quarter there. Betting the draw after not raising preflop with the king jack, like, because I was the original opener, but he got good value. He got like 70 blinds out of it. Okay. That's a deuce. That's half pot. I gotta imagine sometimes he has an ace. We're gonna go for the check raise. And he folds. That's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and bet half pot here. Days makes a lot of moves, but I don't know how many queens he calls with here. Preflop. It's pretty good. Top set over here. I mean, unless this guy has king queen, I think we just go bang bang. Get called, six on the turn. And I think we want to go for the value. I mean, I definitely think we charge. Can he have 8-9? Sure. But that's really the only problem right now. There's usually more draws than whatever. Queen in the river is kind of great. Made the flush here. Yeah, he was on the king jack or the diamonds. 26 full pot. This is kind of great. I mean, it is a five-way pot, but I think we can absolutely just bet here. We're just kind of getting value and preventing, you know, we're not really preventing flush draws, but we're kind of keeping ourselves from getting bluffed. So, unless a diamond hits a turn, I don't think I'm going to stop betting. Eight's kind of great. Stewart's got a big, he might just jam here. All right, well, we can jam on him. He doesn't have enough to make me fold, and I absolutely don't want to let that last diamond come off. So I'm telling him I have something good. He never has King 10. He never has a set. So it's just, do you want to draw? And I think we'd rather just jam on him here. You don't get to play, bro. Look at this, six on the turn. Yeah, he called me on the draw. I mean, he shouldn't take that long. He has every out in the deck. I don't know what he was thinking about. Let's just bet this up. He should have been check-raising the flop. That's fucking hilarious that he almost fucking folded. 12 outs with the to the royal draw. So I guess just 5-8 is the problem here. So we're going to just bet big. Yeah, kind of hard to see a set on the turn. Ace-jack. That's funny that he paid that much. Just gonna bet like we're protecting the king. That's kind of really hilarious. What did that pot cost me? Yeah, I can't believe he fucking took that long to call. At 33. Jack on the turn. Okay, so he doesn't have the fucking flush draw, right? At least he's not supposed to. Sitting for 8 minutes. I think I do want to call. And check. He can have king, queen. He might check back, but he can have king, king, jack a lot. So, yeah, that's fine. I think he got the minimum out of me. I don't think I'm supposed to fold when the jack hits, especially when I have the diamond, because if a diamond hits the river, I can bluff. Because it just looks like a bluff. That is kind of similar to how I would play ace, king, although I probably would have bet through the turn. I want to think I would. That cost me $30. I think we just check because the player is so short. There's no bluff room here. Win, sir. You don't get to play if you don't put money on the table. How come I can't get paid? Because you're not worth playing with. Dummy. Can raise the 10 jack. This is kind of a gapper because GTO wise it should be queen 10 suited, but jack 10 suited has so many great straight possibilities that you can absolutely raise it at a first. It's like the 10-9 here. Can't play the 10-9 out of first, but out of second you can. I mean, that's kind of awesome. I think we just bet. There's not a lot of jacks out here. There's not a lot of pairs that are bigger than me. There's not a lot of fours. I mean, there's the suited ace, four of spades, or diamonds, but I think it's kind of weird. I mean, sometimes this player will have, like, queen jack or something like that, but I doubt ace jack very much. Getting called twice kind of sucks. Every day is being out of the blind kind of really sucks, so I think we just check. This is kind of my concern, really. Because I think he can have the queen jack a lot. But every day is out of the blind, he should just have a four, right? So I don't know if you even want to bet the jack here. So I think you want to bet the four if you have a good four. Like the ace four or something. So he's taking too long. If he bets now, it's just always a four. I had a limp in first and then a raise here and then I re-raised. Ace on the river is kind of whatever. I'm going to 3-bet this one. I don't think there's a reason here to continue. I think Days is going to bet here and win a ton. I think we just check. Or we chop. What the fuck were you calling with behind? 9-9 in a three-way pot. If anybody had bet at any point on that turn, I think that's it for that pot. That's crazy. This is a nice one because if the jack comes off, we make the hand, but even if a 9 or an ace comes off, we can actually play raises and check raises because jack 10 is the most common straight, and it's going to be easy for somebody to see it. So I actually don't mind that gut shot very much. Like if I'm going to draw to a gut shot in, or out of position, that's kind of the one I want. What time is it? Almost 10. Pocket eights a few times today. Bet small. We're absolutely going to raise. He calls. I do think we bet. Sometimes he has like a 9 here, but I think we have to keep betting. He has a 10. I'll bet I could have gotten it if I had 3-barreled. But sometimes he has 2 pair, so I can't really do that. That sucks. Yeah, I should have 3-barreled. Yeah, that's really bad. I made a mistake there. He dunked to block. I raised. He called. I bet. He called. I should have bet again. I'm going to bet this one small. King-queen is a thing, so ace-king would be cautious. The 6 on the turn is kind of whatever. I think we want to bet reasonably. Yeah, a little bit of a pause there did it. But Soj is one of those guys you just have to bet twice. Wow, this table really went down and then it came right back. That's crazy. It was like, we were down to 5 and then we were right back up. So we see a raise out of first and a call out of second. Honestly, this is one of those few that I like calling instead of 3-betting. Because the player should have strong hands, so when we hit the ace, we're kind of gold. But otherwise, we're just firing into... You know, you could be firing into somebody here who's just never going to fold preflop. The call's the problem here. see a raise. I'm gonna 3-bet this one. Don't have to go too big. Player calls. I think I'd rather go bigger, like I have queens. Wow. I get min raised. The funny part is, I should lay down aces in this scenario. Because that's only the move of a set. That's hilarious. I think he thought about it with pocket threes and then spiked it. It's crazy to me how accurate that I've been on seeing that the past like week and a half. Like I've called it like eight out of eight fucking times when I've seen that betting pattern, and I got to see the showdown on all those. Yeah, I've been watching the games while I'm not playing, and it's kind of really helping. I guess it's a form of study, right? A little bit of a downswing here. Okay. Just a 9. The king 9 bets really well there, though. See a 3-bet. I guess we just call this bullshit that this guy's doing. Look at the jam. Well, that's a pretty good flop. We're just praying for diamonds. Look at this, ace, king, and jacks. I'm gonna try raising Soj here. I don't know if I get paid here, but I gotta try. He can have a deuce sometimes, like a good deuce, but I don't think he folds the flush draw at this price. Sometimes he got there with eights. Yeah, ace deuce. It's the only way that can go down. I mean, that's just a super cooler for him. So that was nice. Every day can have king jack, but I think mostly he's gonna have a 10 or a queen here, so I don't think I'm gonna bluff catch. That's a super small bet. I think he's just trying to get called. He's got like two pair. My shit's all dead here. I need batteries. So I'm going to sit out for a minute and just run and grab batteries and come right back. I'll put them back in at the table here. All right, I'll be right back. That little intermission. All right, let's get back on this. $25 to post, sure. Defend my post. Ooh, it's very unseen when we backdoor the hearts. It's very unseen when we backdoor the hearts. Question is, how big does he bet? If he bets big, I think we're just going to fold, but we're going to go ahead and raise that. He could be gating or goading with like ace five or sevens, but I think we just always look like we're bluffing. So, kind of hard for Ron. If he re-raises, it's kind of shit. But he should just have like ace king here. He can have ace queen sometimes, I guess, but I think he would have called by now. Okay. Yeah, he filled it up. He just min. I mean, he fucking min raises. He should go for more, because I can absolutely have way more. And when he has queen five, just an unlikely full house, like he should absolutely go for more. But he goaded me. I could have just called it, but I made a big hand. I mean, the ace coming out is kind of bad, but I don't think I'm supposed to get away from it. Let's check this. Check that. Nah. Wow. Really, bro? I think we gotta call that one. Ooh, because that four gets paid all the way off. Damn it. Can't be a four clubs. What the fuck is this? Isn't that the one? Oh, it's gotta go the other way. I mean, he can have ace queen sometimes, but he should just have like a pair of queens or jacks here, right? So I don't think we're gonna get the fold. It should just always be two pair plus. Hard to have a straight, so it's gotta be like a set, maybe, a set of sixes. a slice. Danny McBride here. The Danny McBride. Thanks, man. Check, check, check. Oh, that is Danny. What's going on, my man? Good to see you, man. Yeah, I'm grinding. Good to see you, my man. Thanks for coming out. You streaming much now, Danny? I apologize, but I don't watch much poker on Twitch. It's just I find it kind of no real reason. I guess it's because I play all the time. I don't know how much people watch something when they're not studying if they're that involved in it, so. Bum, bum, bum. Jack's not bad. Can't really play the fives. I don't mind this too much, but I think I want to raise because there's players behind and I'd rather define the hand. That's pretty good for a Jack 10 flop. Made the straight. So he's supposed to have something good here. He could have two pairs. He could even have... He could have the straight draw with me, but when he calls and that seven comes off, like, he doesn't ever see me as having the Jack 10, so I think whatever calls, he's going to call. Yeah, I took a break, man. I've been back since September grinding, but I took a 1486-day break from streaming. I just kind of, everything went to shit, and I was out of the game for a while. And then I was out of it full-time, and then I was out of it completely for like a year. Never stopped studying, though, and now we're rebuilding. So don't forget to check out the YouTube and all that kind of shit, because we're putting out more content all the time. I got to put out all that stuff on TikTok. I got so many videos I got to make TikToks out of. Like, so many. I must have 30 fucking hands I want to make TikToks out of. I'm trying to work with that thing that stream potato or whatever the fuck it's called, voice potato, where it separates your audio so I can have music on the streams that'll be removed from the VODs. I don't mind this. I don't mind this either. I mean, it's I don't love it out of position, but I haven't seen one 3-bet on this table yet, so I think it's fine to flop the suited king. Just looking for that flush. Sergeant, knock that off. Also because I want music. Like, it's hard for me to listen to music on the stream. Well, that's pretty good. I think I like the check raise here, because this min open doesn't contain much. So I expect to see a lot of super small bets that we can raise. Stacks re-raises. I kind of like this, but I'm going to fold it. It's like I said, having those raise, those opens and folds. Spads over here. Backdoor straight flush draw. Made a pair. I kind of want to bet it to just like block, but we'll just call when this player bets. Haven't for a year, just reformatted my computer because it wasn't allowing me to go live. Ah. That makes sense. Yeah, Twitch does some weird shit. Like, when I came back to it, I was surprised how much I was surprised how able I was to make the scenes to start the streaming. But yeah, there are some things in the formatting of your computer that can keep you from being able to go live, especially with a delay. That's the problem I had when I came back, was that when I had the delay off, streaming was fine. Then I turned the delay on, and for some reason, it wouldn't work, and this is my old computer. I got a new one since then. But I figured out that it was because the amount of memory that I needed to hold for the delay. No good. Really haven't played for a year either. I made 52K last August over four tourneys and blew it all at the casino in a week. Now I'm building back. Ugh. I can't say I've ever done that. Mine is life's gotten in the way, but I mean, that's pretty good, man. Make 52K across tournaments. I mean, you're obviously proven. Like, one tournament is one thing, but, you know, winning several is quite another. This kind of sucks. Like, this is just, like, the worst-case scenario. It's fine. Is that one of those situations where you just kind of blew the money and then you just kind of were devastated that you did it? And then you just walked away from everything? Or did you play too big? Playing too big and getting took, at least you got a learning experience out of it, you know? Pick up a move or two. So this player is not raising. He's just limping everything. So, in that instance, I don't think we have much value in raising, because we want to keep his bad aces in, like he just paid off the ace-deuce to the ace-nine. I think we call. Backdoor straight and flush draws. I mean, it's tricky because he can have the deck, but I'm really only worried about him having, like, ace-eight. I think we can bet the eight here. Gotta try to figure out if he's protecting an ace or if he's... I don't know if he's protecting an ace. He might have been trying to block for the flush. Yeah, he just had a 10. I guess this is why we're not raising this shit, is just to keep him in there. I think we can check this back now. Check that. He's playing 100% of hands. He's just 100% VPIP. So, the thing is, people think you have to learn here. But I did learn... animations over COVID, so I can create sick new overlay in the meantime. Nice! Being out here in Vegas, man, COVID's very much still a thing. It's because we get so many people from all over the world, but our hospitals haven't been below like 130% in like months, which is kind of the way you judge it, you know. Yeah, I knew that was coming. So you definitely don't want to get COVID out here. It's kind of the reason I'm rebuilding. Yeah, there's a couple things I want to do. There's some streamers that I follow that do things like subs can like type certain commands in the chat and it puts up animations and cutscenes and all like that from other things. And I just have to work. There's a couple programs that I'm working with to try to get those animations up. I don't love this, but I do think we have to call. I really don't like it, but wow, everybody called? That's kind of crazy. We shouldn't see a second bet here unless this is exactly ace-king. So I think you got to check ace-queen here even, because you can be up against sets of eights. You can be up against ace-eight, you know, all those kind of hands. I don't think you're up against ace-king hardly ever. So I think when it goes check-check around, if he bets and this guy folds, I think I can call. He's going to have ace-queen sometimes, but he's also going to have some king-queens. But very occasionally, we can have the best hand here, especially when it checks down. Wow. Ace-9, 5-8, jack-10. 3-bet. I don't really love it, but I do think from the button we can call. Wow, how many fucking all-heart flops have I seen in the last hour? It's like six of them, and then everybody's just pounding it. Like, tell me you have an ace without a heart. I think we just check this here. I'll let that go. That's like the fifth or sixth time I've seen an all heart flop. So this was a check and then a bet. I think we just check. Yeah, kind of good. Sevens. I mean, this is a semi-standard raise, but obviously we're going to call. Flopping two pairs is pretty nice. He can have fours occasionally here, but I think we have to bet to get value out of like the check-raising ace-king and ace-queen. Ugh, worst card in the deck. God damn, another suited flop. I'm gonna check it. Ooh, we got a queen on the river. Well, we can bet it now. This is just silly. I'm not gonna bother. But yeah, a lot of stuff's changed, man. It's a whole new channel. So if you see the name of the channel, that's the explanation there. Kind of sticking around the same up point, up about a buy-in and a half. Rinsed your whole roll, got bored during the day. Wow. That's rough. I mean, I've heard those stories a lot, and there was one psychologist that I knew back in the day when I was a, you know, full-time live player back in like 05, 06. And he said that the reason why players will have this big score and go broke, he said that it had something to do with the dopamine in your brain. Like, you know, you put in all this effort and time to learn how to play poker, right? And you make this big score. So it's a validation. And, you know, so that releases dopamine in the brain. And on top of it, you have all this money that you weren't expecting to have, you know, when you walked in, you know, because you had this big tournament score, and that releases dopamine in your brain, and then everybody's around you giving you the attaboys and all like that, and that releases dopamine in your brain. He says you can compare it, and they do this with Super Bowl people, guys who won the Super Bowl who went broke. They do this, they studied them like a bunch of years back on a lower level, on a college level, the, you know, those guys. And it was like, why were there so many instances of drunk driving that ended guys' careers? And it was because of this overmassive flooding of dopamine, and it behaved the same way as people who took ecstasy, because it just overpowered your brain with all the fucking dopamine you could possibly take. And then when that happens, you've depleted the supply that your brain can do. Like, so if you take ecstasy, this is what I know of the drug chemically. I've never done it, but not like I have any problem with it, but it basically just releases all the dopamine in your fucking head, and then you end up for the next couple days wanting to kill yourself, right? Like, you feel worse than you've ever felt in your life because you have no dopamine to, like, get you out of bed in the fucking morning, right? So that's kind of the same thing that happens when you have a big tournament score. And I remember hearing that long time ago. And this is back in, like, 05 when I worked at Imperial Palace and I was still playing. Like, I was just starting to play full-time. And then, like, a year later, I was playing and working at the Venetian. And I won a big tournament that a guy had put me in, basically. Well, he took, like, a third of the action. So my share of it was, like, 12 grand. And he got, like, 4 grand. But I remember at that moment, yeah, look at this. I remember at that moment thinking about what he told me and thinking, holy shit. And I immediately, I got the money and I did what he said. I parceled out a portion of it to blow. And then the rest of it, I immediately deposited in a bank account that I couldn't, and I put a restriction on it so that I couldn't go broke. So he said that's why it happens, is that people kind of, they lose that dopamine and then they're trying to chase the rush and make themselves feel better. Got a day job delivering nuclear medicine until I got back to full-time bankroll again. Nice. Nuclear medicine? What the hell is nuclear medicine? Like, medicine for people who are exposed to radiation? It's kind of scary. Or do you mean, like, chemo? Because isn't chemo a form of radiation, right? Yeah, a lot of us, the most jobs I've ever had outside of playing poker, they were delivering stuff. Uber, and delivered pizzas when I was, you know, younger, and worked my way up to management and that. But had a lot of delivery jobs. I think it's just something that, like, shit, what's his name? The guy who used to drink Greyhounds, he died a couple years ago. Oh, he's one of my favorite players. Why can't I think of his fucking name? Oh, why can't I think of his name? Gavin Smith. Gavin Smith was a taxi driver in Vegas while he was building his role and making himself a player. And he actually was still a taxi driver when he made his first few big scores. And he was very, didn't want to walk away from the job because he was like, I feel like my life will go off the rails. And he wasn't wrong, but he ended up, you know, being a full-time player for like 25 years. Lifelong Star Wars fan yourself? Well, I'm all about the Star Wars, my man. You'll like the YouTube stuff. Go to the YouTube channel, exclamation point YouTube, or just Qui-Gon Broke, spelled the way I spell it on YouTube. And you'll look up the YouTube channel. You'll see my Jedi Mind Tricks, or JMTs, on there. And I do a lot of Star Wars intercut stuff with poker. What did I say? Not Super Bowl, Pro Bowl. Pro Bowl, college players. I mean, you kind of have to have two pair here to bet three times. I mean, I don't really love this. I don't think I could fold, though, as played. Nah, he had a set. I was trying to figure out if he had an ace, but he just bet small the whole way. It plays the same way as, like, the suited king. I should be raising that one, but this table's been a little bit active. Oh, for cancer. Oh, yeah, so like chemotherapy and radiation. Okay, that makes sense. I didn't even know what chemotherapy was till a buddy of mine got cancer, and we were at a strip club when I was a kid. I was like 23. He was like 34. And we're sitting there, and, you know, we're just kind of having a couple drinks, and these chicks are hanging out. And he pulls out a bottle of pills, and he takes one, and the stripper who's on his lap is like, "Ooh, what do you got there? A little party time?" And he goes, "Chemotherapy." And she went, "Oh my God." He got a bunch of free drinks and fucking lap dances after that. He showed her the bottle and she was freaked out. It was, yeah. So do you have to, like, be shielded from the radiation of that? Like, do you have to, like, drive in a fucking lead suit or something? That's crazy. I think we like the 3-bet here. I can understand that. I guess I don't have a sense of direction at the time, but... I had a good year to redirect. Nice. Yeah. I mean, everybody goes through that, man. Like, I think taking breaks is important, and sometimes life makes you take the break, you know? Like, but I'm just rebuilding at the lowest levels. Not the 50 and L is low, but... But it's definitely not enough to sustain me. I think to cover my monthly bills, I gotta be playing 100 and L full-time. That also includes $100 buy-in tournaments. I guess I'm gonna take this other seat just off the camera so you guys can't see it. But I keep seeing these tables pop up and they're good. So, and I'm just trying to get doubled on these other ones before I switch out, so I might as well. I might as well play that one on the side. 8 tables is kind of my limit, but 7 is fine. 3-bet by Stacks, who's not reloading for some reason, which is kind of weird. Check this one. Pick up the double gutty. I guess we'll just check. He can have ace-king a lot and just check it down. Definitely call here. 3 on the river. It's kind of hard to bet any pair here. That's fine. He can have it. If he's bluffing me, that's fine. Ace-king, yeah. That makes sense. Got you on YouTube, but I'm off to sleep, brother. Work at 4 a.m. We'll chat with you again soon. Nice, man. Well, it was great seeing you. Thanks for coming out. And good luck, man, when you getting back into it. Discipline. Discipline, discipline. A big score is just more bankroll. Not a license to go crazy. But yeah, man, good seeing you again, bro. Been a while. This is a little boredom. Yeah, a lot of monotone flops today. Some days are just like that, I guess. I don't want to do that. Hey. 9-7 for a song. It's a little dried up for me. Look at this, quads, and he actually got paid. The flush paid him? Look at this. He bet the full pot on the river and the flush called. Wow. Maybe the guy didn't realize it. Chichi's over there sawing logs. Alright. In position with the flush draw. I think we just check. I mean, I guess we just kind of bet here. I'm going to type in the bet. I want it to look weird. So I'm going to go $4. I got raised. Look at this. Clean river. Second nuts, no good, sir. He's not wrong. I mean, if I have just the ace of clubs, he can absolutely do that. But second nuts, no good. That's why I folded the queen jack earlier. Pre-flop. Not that I'm saying he should, but he definitely shouldn't raise that turn. Because I might just jam the ace of clubs on him, right? Then you don't know what's going on. He probably would have called it, but I mean, it's the king high, but when I call the turn and then he bets half pot on the river, me jamming is kind of hard to get away from, but I mean, it was, you know, basically a min click, so he kind of worked the pot up that size. I think you just want to call there, and then you can raise the river. Like, so if he just calls, right? So let's look at it. So let's say this turn comes off, right? Oh, I gotta do this shit. So, if this turn comes off, and I bet $4 and he just calls, right? Then he has choices. He can actually lead the river. There's only $12 in the pot. He can lead the river for like 10. And then if I, you know, raise him, he can make a decision. But when he raises this here, he's just turned the pot into something he can get the money into. And then he just bets and calls off. I don't like it. I think you just call a turn. I know you're out of position, but if you didn't take the bluffing stance, I don't think I like that much. All right, so we got a double there. That's nice. Took a long time to double on that one. Is this the same table? Yeah, it was. So we're not getting on that one. So we'll get on some winning lists and get the seventh table going on the side. Just gonna bet. Appreciate y'all hanging out, keeping me company. Because otherwise, it just feels like you're working a minimum wage job. pays better than that, but some days you lose money. Crazy how much money we got in on the turn and river. I haven't had a big pair in a while. So I raised and got 3-bet. I raised in first, got 3-bet out of second. Raise this one. This player posted in first. I think I like calling down here if it's just us heads up. Ace is nice. I guess we bet turn. Sometimes he's got jacks here. He's gonna have ace queen a bunch too, and kings. A lot of players can't fold that shit. I don't know if you check ace king on that flop, even though you 3-bet it. So I think we're only beat if we get raised. Yeah. I think he might have had queens or kings, or he could have had like pocket tens even. It's kind of weird. But I think we got the max. Ooh. Flush versus straight on a paired board and you went broke? Well, he didn't have much. He only had like 26 bucks, so. That's that river payoff thing. He improved on the river, so he can't fold at that point. Like, if you flop a flush, or if you flop a straight, it's much easier to get away from it than if you river the straight, you know? Just because it's immediate improvement. That's why you see a lot of people going broke to rivered sets. Or with rivered sets. I don't mind this. Limp, call. This guy takes a long time to act. To the point where I think he's having Wi-Fi issues. Like, I don't know what. Because he's just, like, taking this long and then folding. Like, I don't understand. I don't understand. My delay is too long. If he's trying to snipe me, he can't get there. He's got to be having some kind of connection issue. But players will also do this so that I don't raise, but I mean, I have ace king, I'm going to raise. He might be discoed. Yeah, he just folded. That's hilarious. All right, make the raise. Foldy, foldy. Okay, you limped. You've been sitting here for 4 minutes. You limped. And now you're taking a long time to act. You have $20. I'm going to check. I'm just going to put them in. This is just so face up. Like, it's a king. Like, you just, you don't get to play. You only have $20 on the fucking table. You don't get to fucking play. Like, I'm not even worried about a fucking flush. Like, why? And that's not even, like, why, like, because he wouldn't have bet it or this. No, it's why, because he has $20. I have top pair. That's 40 blinds. We're getting it in. And there's just never a situation where we're not. Sure. Alright, pair of fives. We'll take this flop over here. Maybe with some diamonds. Or this flop. This. Two good flops for Queen Jack. I mean, yeah, I'm going to have ace-king, but he's going to have an ace a lot, too. He can bet that. That's fine. We've checked down too many pots together for him to not, you know, have something there. And he knows I'm not folding ace-king to one bet. So, I've stuck him way too many times when he's had, like, ace-queen. Ooh, got another table. Fold. Set. We're not going to wait on that. Sure. It's a limp pot. I could have the best hand, but I don't think it's worth betting. Let's just bet. Get called. Continue to bet. You're going to draw for three quarters in the flop. Why are you not drawing for three quarters on the turn? It's like you just don't have the philosophy. This is that small stakes inflection point. I could call this for sure. But he could also have, like, pocket tens or something. Ooh, that's a good flop. I'm going to lead it. Snap call. See that? Could have jack 10 for sure. I don't know what... He snap called. I don't know what these people are doing. Like, what's your philosophy? You just need to see me bet twice? You don't have any clue as to what's possibly happening? You're just going to call with overcards on the flop, but not on the turn. Because you think you're going to pull ahead. Like, the amount of times I do that, and then an ace hits, and then I check, and the player bets, and I check raise, and they go broke to my two pair there. It's fucking insane. Like, people just don't have the concept. See a min raise at a second. I'll flop two pair on the other table, too. That you guys can't see. Anything interesting happens, I'll bring it up. I think we want to raise these. I'm just betting twice on everything and getting all the folds. Look at this. Min raise. Raise. Jam. betting all these boards so many times. People are just call one, fold the second. Call one, fold the second. It's kind of hilarious.
I just found so many gray hairs on the right side of my head. I thought they were...
Gray hairs?
Yeah. I thought they were like choo-choo tail hairs.
Can't blame him for all of them.
And then I realized they were growing out of my scalp.
You're like, damn it, Chuchi. Ow! As you're trying to pull them out.
I was like, why is there so much? Oh, yeah,
just the one side of your head, or you didn't check the other side?
No, I checked the other side lightly.
You didn't want to know the truth. Let's play a raise preflop. We just called. I feel like the heart's good here, but I'm not going to draw for it. That's fine. Look at this. Wow. I was thinking maybe I should have called that ace queen, but this is kind of hilarious. Like, is this his move? He just does this till he wins like $20 and then leaves? I mean, I'm raising out of first. I mean, I should have good hands, right? This is kind of goofy, but... Yeah, nice jack 10.
A lot of... I'm gonna be 40 soon realizations happening today. I felt like I...
You got a few years.
A few?
Yeah, a few. Okay. You want less? You got a couple. You're practically 40.
I am practically
40. Now you're practically 40, yes. Less than, I would say less than 2 years. Less than 2 years is practically 40. So you got, you got a few more months.
So October 8th, I can say.
You can always say. You've just always been wrong. You're just the least wrong. I think it's now acceptable to say, you know, I'm almost 40 when you're 38. I think that's okay to say.
Okay.
You had me almost 40 when I was 31. Hmm? Said you had me at almost 40 when I was like 31. You were saying it.
I didn't know you were 31.
33, whatever. We weren't together long until you were saying I was almost 40.
That's because you were 35. I don't know.
And now you see how far away that is.
No, you were still almost 40.
Mm-hmm.
You and this, I was 31 and it was 32. No, maybe I... 31, 32.
No, we met when I was 32. How long have we been together?
10 years. You're 44.
We met when I hadn't had my birthday, so I might have been 33. Because it wasn't past October, so.
Right, it was April, so you were 33.
But still, how much better did you feel at 35 than you feel now? So you can't say practically 40 at 35.
Actually, you know what? I feel better now than I did at
35
for sure.
That's nice. Hey, what's up, DeBoss? Just 3-bet everything. I'm gonna pull up this other table. I think I'm doing good enough. I can handle another one. Kind of enjoying myself. What's up, DeVos?
So Brooke says, we're talking about being 40, and she's like, I realize I'm the oldest of everybody. I was like, what are you talking about? We're the same age. She's like, but yeah, like, I'm in church 41st, and I'm older than everybody. No wonder I feel the way I feel. And I said, Brooke, you're older than me by 3 months.
I mean, but then again, going into her second kid.
Right.
And in her relationship, she's probably 50. If you want to, like, a dog years, she's probably about 55, 60 at this point. You know? We're over here in our mid-20s, just out of shape. You know?
We're just... I got that today at work when I told one of the girls how old I was. She's like, first off, the problem was the gasp.
The what?
The gasp.
She gasped? That's funny.
She said, I said something about being old, and she was like, how old are you? I said, 37, and she went, no way, you do not look 37. I said, see the gas? She said, no, it's just because I was purely shocked because you really don't look 37. I said, but the gas shocked you because it was older than you thought I was, which means that's old, so thanks. I said, in the future, don't gasp.
It's so funny because when I met up with Josh the first time, I was sitting there and we got into the conversation like that, and I said, you know, it's weird, you know, because blah blah blah. I said, I've only come into my own in my, you know, mid-40s over here. And he, you know, no problem for him, you know, like that. And I was like, but it's hard not to feel creepy, you know,
right,
when these youngins come around and like that. And he goes, how old do you think I am? And I went, I mean, you're, you know, mature and this and the other thing, so I'll say maybe 32 or something like that. And he goes, yep. Found out later he was 30. Little fucker aged himself up on me.
I know, he was 27.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know. I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it in writing. I was thinking 28, but I said 32 because he was like, you know, whatever. But I told him, I was like, that's not even a, you know, a consideration. I'm talking about like the 22-year-olds. Come around, and he's like, nothing wrong with that. I was like, I know. And he's like, and in the community, and he went through the whole thing, and I was like, I understand. But, you know, I'm still sitting there. I just want to make sure I'm not occasionally sitting there going,
yeah. No. Please believe I will definitely check you if you start being creepster.
The really tough part is a lot of these little fuckers, like, you see, I've shown you the Instagram ones that got fucking crazy and went to Cali, and they're doing, like,
yeah,
insane. They're always wearing like crazy, like Gucci, and like they got more money than I'll ever have, and like that. And I was just like, oh, anyway. And it's like, and they're like 22 now. And it's right. Like, and I'm finding out, oh shit, they were 19 when I.
Creepy.
And they still say hi.
If I look at my phone and a message from you makes me do that,
good. What was the message from who?
I'm not going to say their name on the stream.
Okay. Does it rhyme with Shmiko?
No. I don't think that's possible. But.
What was the message?
Baby.
Hi, baby, or just baby? That's out of context.
It's the next message. Like, if I respond, then the next message will be, I want you.
Oh, it's a setup. Okay, so it's like, baby. It's like he's calling you.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Eh.
Yeah, no. It just...
Whoa. Not the desired response.
You know, it's one of those things that I had told him I was afraid of happening, that I would wind up just like using him when, for when there's like absolutely nobody else giving me attention.
Is this the military guy?
No, this is Bat Boy.
Oh, God. Well, but didn't he have a girlfriend or something that he was,
yeah,
whatever?
And that ended, and of course he's...
Damn, that was quick. He was that serious that quick. No wonder that shit fucking ended that quick.
Oh, yeah. He's riddled with immaturity and childhood trauma that's going to cause him to make terrible decisions. Matter of fact, I think his mom is actually still paying all of his bills. But anyway.
Whoa. Rough stuff.
And not in, like, the...
Yeah, no.
I'm going to help you out way.
In the you're incapable way?
Yeah. And, no. And the thing is... We don't know if he's incapable. I feel like he's never been given the shot. Mm. She's coddled him. We don't know if he's capable of doing it on his own. So, anywho. Mm. Clearly, I'm just not in the mood for him.
Apparently.
And I have actually had times when I've been truly in the mood to go and hang out with specifically him.
Oh, yeah.
But that's usually when... Everything out when the well is running dry, and I just want to get out of the house.
Right. He's in the you'll do.
And it used to be like cool because he like always had weed and he always had food and he wanted to cook for me and give me booty rubs. So it was like it was the best place to go. I don't know how and when that stopped.
I mean, you should say something.
The last time I went over there, I actually didn't even stay, remember? I was
yeah.
over there a couple hours. And that's never been, like, I've stayed, unless I, like, was going in the daytime, but, like, before we started fucking,
right.
was the last time I went over there and just stayed for a couple hours, came home. So it was just...
I mean, you can say something, you know, like, you should tell them, you know?
He's
obviously somebody that takes shit for granted.
I will when and if I decide it's worth the conversation.
Just don't expect that first time experience.
Oh no, that's what I'm saying. Like he's on the back burner now because how the treatment I get. Like,
right.
You switched up the game, so now the game gets switched up on you. And for some reason, though, he really thinks he has it like that to like. Hit me up and be like, I want you, come to me.
That's what you should check. Just because, like, you're not doing this guy any favors by protecting his ego. He's going to...
Oh, no, I don't protect his ego. A lot of times when he says that, I just respond with LOL.
I don't know if that's cold or...
Well, because that's how it usually makes me feel when I read it. So, I usually say, LOL, you're cute, or LOL, that's funny, or...
That's hilarious.
Sometimes I just say LOL. And then sometimes I just don't even ever respond to it. And yes, I make him like say something else.
Man, he three-bet me pretty quick.
I'm about to get Chuchi comfortable.
You wish, bitch. That's 7 on the riv ball. So I guess we just do this, right? Because he's going to never have much. So this dude check raised me. Yeah, I think we're going to go for the bet here. So he check raised me on this flop minimum. So I think he was trying to block for the flush. And then he called after I bet the turn. That's hilarious. See, look, and he got that. This is fucking hilarious. He check-raised me on the flop two block to keep me from betting the turn. And then he fucking drew anyway. What a fucking loser. He fucking drew anyway on this turn. I mean, I could have bet bigger, but I still don't think he folds. He's a fucking loser. That's fucking awful. And then he just fucking straight rips it. Like, I can have fucking sets there. I can have the ace-king with the ace of hearts unless... But of course I can't because he fucking has it. That is some loser-type shit. Well, we were up a couple buy-ins until those hands. All right, so now I'm just up a buy-in and three quarter. That's fucking hilarious that he fucking played it that way. He's so fucking trappable. Fucking three bet him and he fucking does that shit. Like a fucking loser. And he still drew. Still drew when I bet. Raised him on that flop. He check raised me to draw. That's the only reason why he did that, was to draw. And then he still fucking drew when I bet the turn. Way too big. He's no way he can call that there if he only has heart outs. Like, if he had the ace-jack of hearts, I could see it. Then he can draw, but even then, he's supposed to lead the turn. Lead the turn for half pot. Take a chance on winning without relying on the deck. This is kind of... I think I have to call. I get aces on the other table. A lot of shit going on a lot of tables. Let me check this one. Let me check this back. I'm probably gonna lose to a jack here. Yeah. I guess we can bet two pair. So I three bet these aces on this other table, then bet super small on the flop of 6-6 deuce. And queen hit the turn that also could be a possible backdoor flush draw. If he rivered queens on me, it's going to kind of suck. Look at this. He flopped quads. Second time in 2 days, I had pocket aces and 2 sixes flopped, and I lost to quads. But I'm never supposed to check this here because I can't fold. He only had fucking $40. That sucks. Wow. I just got super unlucky again. 6-6 deuce is like the safest fucking flop I could have. Yesterday it happened. The flop was ace-6-6, and the other guy had quad sixes, and I had aces full of sixes. Wow, that's really frustrating. That's really frustrating. And I'm betting super small. And of course I'm going to jam all rivers, because he never has a queen. Wow, that's really shit. That was annoying. This table's dead. Been playing a while. That really just annoyed me. The last 10 minutes. Ugh. Just cost me 2 buy-ins. King of the river. Gee, I wonder what he had. God damn it. I'm going to call it. That really aggravated me. Running into the quads, the guy sucking out on me, getting set over set. That really aggravated me. So I want to buy in. I'm at 41.83. But I was only up like another $100, but that's just annoying. Well, yeah, I'm realizing that like the state that I'm at right now because of the size of my bankroll, like I'm playing well and I'm not like overextending risk and I'm getting good value and shit like that, but I'm kind of noticing that I do have a higher tilt factor than normal, so and I'm also hungry and it's late, so I'm gonna call it, and I don't know how tomorrow's gonna go. I honestly don't know what I'm gonna play. I may play early, but I might be in the late schedule. I'm not sure yet. I gotta look it over, but yeah, that just really was frustrating. So positive note, I'm just gonna end ahead $50. And I'm gonna go ahead and kill it here before I tilt off a bunch of cash. So I'll see you guys later tomorrow at some point, and have a good night.